It's time to have a look at the numbers and see who are the best performers so far in the Premier League. Mo Salah, outstanding. 15 goals, on course to win his third Golden Boot. Also top of the assists. In fact, he's got, 24 goal involvements, twice as many as the next highest player at this stage. Edison, on course to win a third successive Golden Glove. But Jose Sa of Wolves has the best save ratio so far. Trent Alexander-Arnold, highest suspected assist, but Bruno Fernandes is creating the most chances in open play. Alan Saint-Maximin, star for Newcastle tonight, brilliant goal for him, has had the most carries that have led to a chance, 19 so far. Joao Cancelo with the most passes in the final third. Christian Norgaard of Brentford with the most tackles, edging out the Palace pair, Conor Gallagher and Tyrick Mitchell. And a word for West Ham there as well, because top of possession one is Declan Rice. Pablo Fornals has made the most pressures. And the player who covered the most distance in the Premier League last season, Thomas Soucek, is out in front again. Well, we always like to keep our receipts here on Monday Night Football, and we do sometimes ask Jamie and Gary to make their predictions and hold them to account. And this is what we did from August, the start of this season. So, Jamie, how do you feel, first of all, about the picks that you went with at that stage?
I think I'm looking quite well there, actually. Brighton have done well. I think City are a big favourite to the title. Man United, I mean, that was pretty obvious, wasn't it? Was staring at you in the face. Mo Salah was going to be the top goal scorer. Emile Smith-Rowe's on fire, 4 goals in his last 4 games.
How do you feel about you want to watch?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not trying to back out. I mean, I wanted to actually watch Jadon Sancho. Actually, I didn't think he was going to be, because I'd spoken so much about how well he'd done at Dortmund, and I think last season, at the end of last season, we didn't put him in our Euro squads.
Yeah.
And we got a lot of stick from that, certainly on social media. How can you not put Sancho? But I hadn't seen enough of him. And when I'd seen him in an England shirt, I hadn't been that impressed. It was one to watch, as in, I want to see what he's about. Listen, it hasn't started well for him. He's still a young player. He's got plenty of time, a few years at United. But you definitely want a bit more from him, no doubt.
Well, Gary, let's have a look at what you went with back in August. Mm. How do you feel about it?
I think the top one I'm all right with. The second one, I think Liverpool, you can swap them with Manchester United. That will be wrong. Overachievers, I still think Everton will finish strongly. I think underachievers.
Why?
I think.
Look, what would overachieving mean?
We are only halfway through. They've had a lot of injuries. They've had Calvert-Lewin out. They've had Richarlison out. They've had Doucouré out at times. So they will be all right. Underachievers. You said Manchester United. I agree with you. They are underachieving. I've said Arsenal. To be honest, Arsenal, you can flip a coin with them. In 3 weeks, we can be talking
but
about
right
Arsenal.
Now, they're overachieving, aren't they?
But at the moment, I'd say they're doing absolutely as they should be, but they could still let you down in a few weeks. They're not someone you could trust wholly, I don't think.
All right, so let's update a few of those at this halfway point. Both of you gone for Manchester City. I think there's not too much reason to change that, is there? No, all right, what about the top four then? This might be a bit more interesting. And the boys can be a bit emotional sometimes. He's changed it well in the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, he has.
Go on, explain.
Well, I actually think Liverpool this season, I put Chelsea to finish second at the start of the season. I didn't expect Liverpool to almost go back to what they were 2 years ago. I think Liverpool.
Well, I think we've all got those as our top three.
Yeah, but yeah, okay. And Tottenham, on the back of sort of Conte coming in, watching that performance tonight, I think was very, very worrying going forward
for Manchester United. So you substituted Manchester United and you went Spurs, Gary.
No, I'll stick with Manchester United. I think they'll sort themselves out. Even though it's been poor the last two games, they have got 7 points out of 9. They're still picking up points against obviously teams near the bottom of the league. I do think they've got a favourable month. And they've got to play a lot better than that. But I do think they'll pick up a lot of points in that month. And you'll see that Arsenal have got a few games coming up that are more difficult. Tottenham will play. You know, Tottenham have had 6 games under Antonio Conte. He's done brilliantly, don't get me wrong. And I love their performance against Liverpool. But they've had 5 at home and only 1 away. So I think when that balances out a little bit, you'll see a change to that.
Are you still glad United never took Conte?
No, but I don't think Conte was a fit for United. I know people disagree with me, but I don't think he will. I think United will get the right manager at the end of the season for the longer term.
Any thought on who that would be?
I mean, you're a pundit.
Offer an opinion, that would be great to this stage.
Well, I don't predict who's going to go down. I don't predict who's going to be a manager. I don't know who's the next manager.
Who would you like to be the manager at this stage?
I'd like Pochettino to be the next manager. because I think he's got experience in the league. I think he would play the right type of football. I think he feels like the moment for him to step up. He's got to Champions League finals. He's managing now big stars and big characters and personalities, which I think will help him. And I've always liked him, always loved the way in which he's operated. I think he fits the club. He works with young players well. He gets the best out of players. He's a good coach, but also I think he works people the right way. So for me, it would be him. But he's got a job at Paris Saint-Germain, and if he does well there, then they obviously won't let him go.
We know that you're a bit sensitive about picking teams that are going
like
down,
picking teams
or predicting
that go down,
teams are going down. No. So we haven't asked you to do that. So we've said there are four teams in the bottom four right now, obviously. Who's going to stay up? Watford, Burnley, Newcastle or Norwich? And both have plumped for Burnley. I probably would have predicted that, Jamie. Why have you gone for Burnley?
It's just the defensive record and how they go about it. I don't think they will panic at any stage, even if there's four or five games to go of the season. The pressure isn't really on them as much because they never spend big money. We sort of expect them to be in this sort of position. And as I said, I just think they have a way of playing, maybe slightly different from other teams. I think Norwich are gone. I think a lot will ride on Newcastle doing well and obviously the January transfer window, and I think Watford were in there as well. But out of all those, they've got the experience of being there and doing it before, and I'd stick with
that. Well, that leads me to the question about Newcastle, who we watched tonight. Yeah. Why do you think they are still going to struggle?
I've got no surety on that prediction around Burnley. I think, to be fair, it's the most worried that I've ever been about Burnley going down. Not that I'm worried about it, but it's the most worried that I've ever been. Not because Burnley have regressed. I think the quality of the league is so good. It's so good. And if Newcastle and Leeds play to their standard that I think they can do, I think Burnley could be in serious trouble. The reason I've said I think Burnley will survive is because I think I trust them in terms of consistency more than the rest.
But let me ask this on Newcastle. Do you think we will see a different Newcastle at the start of February, end of January?
Look, Leeds and Newcastle are both worrying me. Leeds are flaky. They are flaky. I know they've got injuries at the moment, but they are a little bit flaky. But if they get Bamford and Calvin Phillips back and the others, then they should just be OK. Newcastle, they keep pointing towards this January transfer window as if it's going to be some sort of like magical moment. They're still going to have a massive amount to do. But it could be Burnley, I've said, just because I trust them and they've done it before. But I am more worried about Burnley than I've ever been before. Just the quality of the league, I think, is the best I've ever seen it.